strats ATG wants to run right here, if they got any good bad side strats. But pretty much on this map, you want to make the most of the boom shot, and both teams are going to be able to get sniper and grenades uncontested.
Well, that's exactly right, so I'm really looking forward to seeing which players actually get their hands on those crucial power weapons, because grenades can really make or break, especially when you're on that cog side and maybe go for the Hail Mary shot on the boom. Remember, weapon slide going to be considerably a considerable amount more difficult to pull off, so one well-placed nade could spell disaster for either of these teams.
Exactly. So, of course, we all want to see Starbrace right here, because he let us know the tone of this match, okay? Guys, we're on Fuel Depot. Let's get it popping. On board here with Starbrace, and he's going to be getting this free snipe right here. So, right here, he wants to really try to lock down anybody that's coming through this front door. He's going to rotate, and we're also going to see Boomshot will get picked up here. It's going to be by Febreze here. He needs to, he's going to get taken out by Gambler right there.
Yep, there's that Hail Mary, Nate, predicting that Boomshot pick makes him pay for it, but the Nate actually taking out his teammate here, so actually has something to fear for his own team more than the enemy right now, and that's going to allow the side of ATG to pick up three members. Hope in the last position alive here. He's staring down the barrel of a loaded Nasher, and he's going to get taken out.
You know what? I had the pleasure of teaming with Gambler at one point.
Yep.
This guy's nades, man, are ridiculous. He got two kills right there for a squad. Was trying to almost put his team up on the board right there, but his team was just not able to close out, but he did kind of open up.
Yeah, that was an excellent cross-map nade to be able to predict that boom shot, as well as clean up a few of the members of TMG. But let's see how these guys play now that they are on the slow side. We know they favored that boom shot strat on Locust, but looks like we will be seeing Energetics going in mid, around the back, sorry.
And here we go, on board here with Energetics. He's gonna come in, he's gonna be on bad side, he's gonna try to prevent this boom pickup. He's gonna go right down, get his hands dirty, gonna get the free boom pickup. He's gonna rotate over with his teammate up the ramp. He's gonna lose one teammate right here, 3v3 situation. His other teammate will drop. He's gonna stay up, 3v2 situation. His team's down to 3v1, and he's gonna go down, so we're gonna switch on over here to try and push me, but he's gonna be down already.
Look at that. You can hear the ATG squad getting animated right now. They know what trash talk the other team did put out in that post-game interview, the pre-game interview rather, so they know exactly what's at stake here. It's not just a victory, it's also the pride. These guys on the side of TMG put out a challenge, and ATG plan to show up to it.
And I want to go on board here with Vader here, leading his team in points right now. He's going to be going back door to try to help his teammate. He's going to take some pressure off the opposite back door side so his teammate can really get boom. And we're going to see him throw that smoke back there, try to help his team out. They're going to rotate over. We got some nades over here. Energetics with the double kill. He's helping his teammates. He's going to get the one down, and he's going to take out Gambler right there.
Energetics
is going off.
He is coming up clutch right now, and he said he had no words for the other guy on the pregame interview. He's saying it all right now. Currently 5-1, 800 points, and they're leading 3-0.
Did you just see that screen right there? That's silence, okay? Let's take a look at this. Silence. Okay. On board right now with Energetics, okay? He made a great play with Naze last round. We're going to see what he can do right now, rotating the helipad.
Look, this guy, he seems to have a third eye just kind of sitting at the top of the map. Munchins does go down early on Gambler. Might be picking up that one. Freebreeze gets one of his own, accidentally taking out his own teammate. So now they are down 2-4. This could be TMG's chance to pick up their first round of Fuel Depot.
Exactly. We're going to see if they can kind of make up for it. On board with Try and Push Me, he does have the boom here for the COG team.
Yep.
And he's looking for these last two men out right now. He's looking, trying to figure out where they are. I want to say they're going to be a cross match. We got a 1v1 here on the helipad. Energetics trying to make something happen for his team, and he gets one. Can he get out is the real question.
Oh.
He's not going to be able to. Starbrace gets that headshot.
Yeah, so now it's a 3v1. The last member of ATG trying to get himself out of there, but Try and Push Me with that precision boom shot cleans him up, and they get their first round on the board.
That's a good round to get on the board right there, but ATG needs to not let that drop their momentum. They still got a good two more rounds to get in their flow, stay in sync with each other.
That's exactly right. We're jumping on board. Try and Push Me one more time out with Energetics. And how can you not? His nades have been on point all series. I'm going to be throwing that smoke out early, picking himself up those frags. Let's see where he chooses to use them.
Exactly. He wanted to use these frags to kind of cut off anybody that's coming to the front door. He's not going to get too much static, but they actually have made it in. He's going to nade out the boom shot for security. Can he get one? Not going to pick up a kill right there. The second nade is out. Starbrights is going to get one. He's going to go down. Starbrights making plays happen right now.
Yeah, picks himself up a very nice triple now, trying to go for one more to make it. The quad can't seem to land. His shots gets it in the end. Times it well. And look at that. There's the shots we've been looking for.
Now they're starting to get that momentum.
That's it.
They don't want to tie his. ATG needs to win this right now.
Yeah, they need to clean it out or they're versing a very powerful beast. The squad are finally up in arms, roaring fires under them right now. TMG, they came to play and they came to win.
You know who I want? I want Try and Push Me because he's so focused. I saw him right there on Starbright screen and he has the front spine for his team. So he's going to be coming in here getting that boom shot. Actually, I take that back. He's not. He's going to rotate out. He's going to rotate around, put some shots behind these guys. He's going to be on the flank right here. And let's flip on over here to Starbright. He's going to be moving inside too with the rest of his teams. Nades are going to be out, not connecting right here. Him and his teammates got a team fire one down. They're going to get the man advantage right here, Rogi.
Oh, look at that. The nades coming in though, actually clutch coming out of ATG, but they only have two members left. It's a 2-on-2, two versus one. This could be an ATG. They have the man advantage. It's all up to Hope. He's in a bad position with only a pistol to work with. ATG just need to angle him out and they've got the perfect weapon to do so. It's the boom shot.
Yeah, they do get that boom. This is a 2v1 for the bread right here. You cannot allow Phillies to clutch this, but Phillies, he can do it, man. Phillies is one of those underrated players out there. He's been on the scene for a while. He's been on the scene for years. And right here, if you get this man sniped, it's over, but they cannot allow that to happen.
No, they know exactly what they're up against right now. Only one round away from taking this first map. It's all on the back of Phillies. Can he clutch it out? He has eyes on both of the players right now. They're just waiting for him to make a mistake. ATG are in a position to just hold on tight, wait for the boom shot spawn, make Phillies come to them, and it's exactly what they're doing here.
I think they know that he might possibly want snipe right here. They're not going to allow him to get it.
No.
You know, they're staying right in front of that little slit on the ramp so that if he does, they can kind of shoot his feet together and probably down him. And Phillies knows that. That's why he's rotating. He just knows he needs to make a play on Boomshot.
Look, he's just looking for a little bit of damage here and there to kind of dissuade the push that's coming in. A lot of damage taking a full red, though. Where is the push from ATG? They have a Boomshot. They have two members alive, but they're playing it by the book, cool, calm, and calculated. They don't want to overextend their reach here and find themselves in a bad way. He's full red, though. They're just looking for one boom. Maybe one more pistol. Boomshot should be spawning soon. Trying to bait out the Lancer here.
Oh, they had a boom. I'm surprised they didn't send an original boom.
Oh! Phillies gets the first one, dodges the first boom. Can he get the execution? Not going to find it with this shot. There comes the revive. There comes the boom. And ATG secure the round.
Munchies keeping his composure. Phillies went to go get that shot on the ground. He missed
it. So close.
But good job. Good thing he didn't take a second shot. Honestly, they had one more boom shot. I probably would have played it different. I probably would have had the boom shot guy flank around the ramp, had the other guy step back and let him, you know, force him to come down. But hey, it still worked. They took it a little bit extra slow, but that's what you need to do to really get that round. They couldn't lose that because they whole team morale would have been down.
That's exactly right. If you lose from a position of two versus one with a boom and a second one on the way, but you got to commend Phillies. He basically played that perfectly, constantly popping out the damage, was able to get that down. Unfortunately, wasn't able to execute it. That could have been an entirely different round if things had gone slightly in his favor.
Yeah, definitely could have been. Well, we go on to map number two. We finally get to see Mansion for the first time today, which I'm actually surprised about.
Yeah, I thought more people would be coming into this game, maybe preferring that Mansion, considering just how shotgun heavy it is. A bit of a chance to show off your Nasher prowess and really stick it to the enemies.
Yeah, and I want to say I think this is ATG's map pick right here.
Yeah.
I think this is definitely their map pick that they wanted. So we're going to see why, you know. We're going to see.
Sure.
But for all you folks at home who don't know too much about Mansion, Mansion is the fastest map in Gears of War.
Definitely, without a doubt.
Average about 40-second rounds because all teams are fighting for the boom shot and they're fighting for nades outside, and it's so compact where that it's always action happening within the first 20 seconds of the round.
Well, that's the thing. If you want to go for that sniper rifle up on the inside, it's so far out of the way and such a long detour. By the time you get it, your whole team's either dead or the enemy has the boom shot and the nades, and that's just such a disadvantageous position to work with. So if they do, if TMG do win this mansion, we are going to be going into gridlock as the final map.
Exactly. And just to touch on a little bit more on when you was talking about sniper,
yeah.
You know, a lot of, you know, the explosive weapons are supreme. Nades are supreme. Boomshot is supreme. You really want to focus more on those weapons, and that's why this map plays out a little bit more like that. And the only time you may see Snipe picked up, if you got that one straggler who's just trying to make a play because his whole team died, yeah. And he was playing a nade position, and you'll see him kind of run off and say, hey, let me see what I can do.
What are we predicting? Who's going to be the front runners for these teams, you reckon, Blaze?
Man, I don't know. We're going to try to catch these spawns coming out. And as you guys can see, the first flyover today for Mansion, you're going to see that sniper right there between those red couches.
Who even knew this part of Mansion existed, right?
Exactly, right?
It's like the DLC for Mansion.
Exactly, at the competitive level. You know, I remember those old 2006 GB matches. That used to be the strat. Go in and get sniped. Because Snipe actually downed you back then.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
So somewhat viable until people just really start getting good with Boomshot. All right, we're going to hop on board here. Going to try to – well, actually, Phillies is a good choice right here.
Yeah, he did a great job in that last round to try and secure it for his team. Doing well work with that Nasher. Has the pistol out right now, getting some nice actives, but they're playing on that eye pillar. Try and push me. Does get the down on Munchie's Boom. Maybe coming through here. Here comes Marcus going on, but Gambler just turns on him, completely outplays him, gets the double off the back of that one.
Gambler did a such good job playing that middle statue, and he's one of the guys that he's in the action right away.
Yep.
He's in there. He's trying to make plays happen. He's the first one to get to the fight.
Look, and these guys are playing phenomenally right now. So if this was ATG's map choice, I'm sure they have some plans, maybe some spanners to throw in the works and try and catch these guys off guard, or maybe it's going to just be all on the back of those Nashes. But already, look at the aggression coming out here. But Gamblers, he's got something to say about that.
Yeah, that boom shot's going to go out. He's going to get headshotted right there by Starbrights. Starbrights is at the nades. He's going to have a 1v1 right here. That guy's going to back down. His teammates is dropping. Starbrights needs to get into the fight.
Opting for the frags, he's just throwing them over, looking for anyone. He does lose a member in the process. That was their round to lose, and unfortunately, it might look like it. He's in a 3v1, but he's not looking to surrender. The Lancer coming out, gets the first down. Someone's flanking him. Can he get the one shot? Doesn't get it. Munchie secures that one with a little cheeky teabag to finish it off.
He's not able to get that one. We're going to have to hop up Munchies this round. Okay, you know, I've always been very superstitious that, you know, when you start humping and start talking trash, like mid-game, karma always comes back around and gets you.
Well, let's see if your prediction's on point here, Blaze. We're jumping on with Munchies.
He's going to be on board here with Munchies this round. And he's going to come out. He's going to get that early smoke to try to block as much vision as he can. He's going to be coming up here. He's going to be hitting the mid statue. Come around here. Going to take some shots. Shotty's out. Trying to get the first shot on him. Is he going to be able to get it?
He's bouncing around left, right, and center. He does get taken down by Try and Push Me, but he's got the teammates to back him up. So it's all just a ruse. Starlight, so is able to get the kill onto Energetics using his pistol. Well, Gambler picks up that one. Now it's a 2v1 in favor of ATG.
And that's going to be the round right there for those guys. They're going to get up on the board with that one. 2-1 in favor of of ATG right here.
Yeah.
So, I mean, sorry, of TMG.
I know, it's confusing,
yeah,
right?
ATG, TMG. Yeah. But 2-1 in favor of those guys. They're making a great job right there. They should actually hop on board back with Starbright because he's doing a great job playing these nades. He's throwing good smoke for himself at nades to try to block off the vision, but he's going to actually do a little rotation. He's going to go to Boom with his teammate, try to put some extra pressure right here. Gambler's going to go down, going to hop on over here with Energetics. He's going to get into the Boom shot. He's going to take a shot. He's going to get one down. Boom is free, and he will pick it up for free, but he does not need to use it.
Well, we said Mansion was a fast map, and you can see why. That was about a 10-second round. I think they spent more time running from spawn than they did fighting. It was all over as ATG just steamrolled them in that round.
No, they definitely did. Energetics wants to win this round right here. He wants to send Starbrights home. He said, man, after all that mess you talk, you're about to play this up.
Look, he's tasting that post-game interview. He's ready to start talking some smack of his own, but the smoke grenades are in. The shotguns are out. Energetics looking to try and find a chink in the armor here. Going for that player on Bathtub. You can see the rush coming through on the pillar. Not going to happen. Takes try and push me out. Now here come the COG members all in fall, but Phillies is able to get one. So does Starbrights. Vader picks up one of his own. It's a 2v1 boom shot. Now in the hands, but he gets taken out by Starbrights. Nate's on point. The 1v1 playing on his eye. Starbrights, he's so passionate about this. Can he do it? It's so close. He's not even hurt right now. Looking for one. Looking for a few more shots. Gets the down.
Oh my God. Starbrights performing under pressure. He did not back down from that fight. Not one bit. He was like, I gotta fight this. I'm not giving up boom shot. This is it. And you just see that focus on his eyes.
Yeah, he is so determined to win this. He put out some serious predictions here. And if he can't back them up, he's gonna be hearing about it for the next few months. So this is more than just pride on the line. This is everything to him.
Rogi, I swear his beard just grew about 2 more inches after that fight. Okay? Hey, they're gonna do a 2 nade strat. He's gonna grab these nades, toss 1 nade, toss 2 nade. Kobe!
Can he go for anywhere? Waiting for those explosions to come through. Is able to get the down on the back of that one. Looking for the next member though. Boom, in contention, has been picked up. We saw him win this fight last though. Gets the RP, does get taken down by Energetics. Energetics in a 2v1. Try and push me, takes him out. Now it's all on to try and push me to keep the dream alive. Can he take this round? One more shot, should do it.
Oh!
No! Freebies takes him out.
To tie the game for Breeze. Coming clutch right there, Rogies. They could have ended that. We would have saw our first map 3 of the tournament, but for Breeze said no shot. You're not Starbright, okay?
Yeah,
I don't know who you think you are. So we're going to have to stay on board with him going into this next round. He's about to get this camera time, folks.
Look, Febreze just clutching it up there. That was the game-winning play for TMG, but they're not going to go and look at the aggression coming out of ATG. They're playing with all the confidence in the world. Vader gets taken down immediately. Try and push me with Phillies watching his back. Now it's all on Starbright, throwing in those nades. Can he make them connect? It's a 3v2 in favor of ATG. They want to end this right now. 2-on-2. Nade comes through. They have the boom shot. It's a 1-on-1. Energetic versus Starbright. It couldn't be better than that. The post-game interview. He wins in the end. Energetic takes it in a 2-0.
Oh my God. That was it. That was for the brand.
Oh my God.
You almost thought it was over.
Oh my God. It's a 1v1 between Energetic and Starbright. It doesn't get better than that. Energetic takes it. You can see what this meant to him. Look at the man. He's so excited. He's absolutely animated.
Silent.
And Starbright, your silent knight over in the blue corner, gets defeated after throwing some serious shade.
I just want to say, for that man's first match on main stage at MLG, those are the moments that you live for. Ooh. Those are the moments when you clutch on main stage, the whole crowd is behind you, everybody's watching you, and you come out on top and you perform.
That's career defining.
That's a moment that you never forget, and that's an MLG experience. That's a LAN experience. That's what everybody's plays for, and that was exciting. We were standing up. I'm sweating right now.
You can't get that anywhere else. This is why the LAN environment is so much different. You cannot